So it's going to be in here. So I cleared out this entire room for the past couple days. It's going to go right here, where I have it marked off. It's about 10 and a half feet by 4 feet and weighs about a ton. And this is going to be the studio. So I've been wanting to buy an SSL console, like an old SSL console, for probably about 10 years or so. I think it was the Lord Algae Brothers have been telling me I should get one for a long time, and I finally just kind of pulled the trigger on it. I finally found the one that I really wanted from a producer named David Bendith, who made a lot of great records on it, and somebody I've known for a long, long time. And it came available, so I finally just found the one I wanted and bought it, and it's coming in today. I did on this record, for whatever reason, it's something inside of me. I don't really know why. I mean, I came home from the 13 Voices tour, and the next day I jumped into starting writing new songs, and I didn't stop. I haven't stopped.
Frank, do you like today?
I think what happens with every record with this band, it's like the progression gets more complete towards that sound that defines Sun 41. But it's always progressing, and we always want to change and kind of morph and be closer to that perfect sound we're always searching for. And I think that's something that a lot of bands do.
Some of these songs were like I swear, like, these are the best songs that Derek's written in a long time.
Everybody may have ideas from the day before, and it can take the song in a totally different direction or elevate it somehow. And that's what's so awesome about getting together for pre-production.
Definitely is like when you see a part change the whole concept of a song and put a whole new life on it and take it a different place, which is what's great when we're all in a room together.
You know, I write songs and I never really know if they're any good or, you know, what they're gonna sound like with the band, because they're just kind of my demos and they're drum machine, and I don't really, you know, they don't have a lot of excitement to them, and I send them to the guys and they learn them, and then when we get together and you play them for them, they've already done their homework and everyone knows the song, so the first time we play it, everyone knows it already, and it has life instantly. The second we play it for the very first time, it's like it all new already, and it just kind of, so much better, and all of a sudden they come to life from the demos. Weird to anybody, or does the song seem normal, or does anyone have any ideas to change it?
New stories. That's part of what makes new songs so fun to work on and so fun to be a part of. Because everything we've ever done is kind of like Derek telling a story that personally happened to him or happened to somebody else. It's like, I would say storytelling.
You know, we've gone through all these journeys in our career, and we're actually still finding new things to evolve into, and, you know, so that's pretty exciting.
Yeah, and the chorus, I was using the jam,
too. Yeah, it should be more like...
You weren't
just hearing it. Yeah, I say we just get a couple of these.
Yeah, totally.
Let's start from the top. Start it again from the top? I'll do that part. Alright, let's try it again.
But closer to that perfect sound.
Journeys in our career
elevated somehow.
Evolve.
New stories.
They come to life.
Closer to that perfect sound. Elevated.
Evolve.
I love working on new material. I'm always playing instruments and always writing, so I'm stoked for Derek to have songs and to work on them and give them my 2 cents, whether we use it or not, and turn the songs into something special.
These are all Cone's old basses. Just excited to play new music, and like even more excited now playing it, thinking about the live shows and like thinking about that part of it.
Because even Zumo has a pad where he can, you know, we can program keyboard sounds to that, and he can actually have like, he's got 9 pads that he can, you know, hit sounds and stuff. So I mean, we're kind of covering a lot of bases between just the 5 of us, and I wrote music with that in mind.
It seemed pretty good, right?
It's a hard one to just come out of nowhere, and maybe back it up a bit.
And I think there was a song or two on this that I specifically left to kind of work on as a band, because I just didn't have any more ideas on my own. And I think the ideas that came from that were exciting, and it really, you know, completed those songs.
The snare roll is in the right spot, it just needs to be a little longer.
Looking at Frank and seeing him smile after he does a crazy fill is like, it's just one of those things that warms your heart and makes you feel a part of something that is beyond business, beyond family, beyond friendship. It's playing in a band.